Class 6 IMO Level 2 Mathematics question number 16. A storybook costs m rupees and a bag costs 5 rupees more than a storybook. Find the cost of one bag and three storybooks in the terms of m in the simplest form. Cost of one storybook is equal to m rupees, while cost of one bag is equal to m rupees plus 5 rupees. Therefore, cost of one bag and three storybooks is equal to rupees m plus 5 rupees plus 3 m rupees, which is equal to 4m rupees plus 5 rupees. Mathematics question number 17. The ratio of number of male workers to the number of female workers in a manufacturing firm is 3:5. If there are 30 more female workers than male workers, then how many workers are there altogether? Male workers is to female workers is equal to 3:5. Male workers by female workers, which is equal to 3/5. So, male workers is equal to 3/5 into female workers. That is equation 1. Given female workers is equal to male workers plus 30. So, substituting equation 1, we can find the value of female, that is 75. Now, from equation 1, substituting the value of female, we can find the value of male workers, that is 45. So, the total number of workers is equal to female workers plus male workers, that is 120. Mathematics question number 18. Soumya and Prashi had an equal amount of money. After Prashi bought a book that cost ₹79.9 and Soumya bought a watch that cost 493.4 rupees. Prashi is left with 2 times as much as Soumya is left with. How much money did Prashi have at first? Let us take the initial amount of Soumya and Prashi to be n. So Prashi bought a book, so left out money with her is n minus 79.9. Soumya bought a watch, so left out money with her is n minus 493.4. Given Prashi is left with 2 times as much as Soumya is left with. With this information, we can write an equation to find the value of n. So, the value of n is equal to 906.9. That is the initial amount they had at first. Mathematics question number 19. How many right angles are formed when the hour hand of a clock moves from 1 2 to 8, second one 6 to 3. Angle made by hour hand to make a full rotation is 360 degrees. That is for 12 hours. Therefore, from 2 to 8, that is 6 hours, angle made by hour hand is 180 degrees. In 180 degrees, we have two right angles, that is 90 plus 90, 180. So, two right angles. So, the right angle formed by hour hand to move from 2 to 8 is 2. Similarly, from 6 to 3, 9 hours, angle made by our hand is equal to 360 by 12 into 9, that is 270. So, the right angles formed by our hand to move from 6 to 9, that is 3 right angles. Mathematics question number 20. What fraction of the given figure is shaded? The total number of rectangles in the given figure is equal to 24. Total number of shaded rectangles is equal to 10. So, fraction of shaded rectangle is equal to 10 by 24. And the fraction of unshaded rectangle is equal to 1 minus 10 by 24, that is 7 by 12. Mathematics question number 21. The place value of digit 5 in 85,30,721 is dash times the place value of 2 in 72,589. The place value of 5 in the number is 5 lakhs. The place value of digit 2 in 72,589 is 2000. So, the place value of digit 5 in 85,30,721 is 5 lakh by 2000, which is equal to 250 times place value of digit 2 in the number 72,589. Mathematics question number 22. Mary, Charu and John have 25,000 rupees 75 pais, 18,000 rupees 79 pais, 8,000 rupees 45 pais respectively in their personal bank accounts. How much money do they have altogether? Money they have altogether is equal to money Mary has plus money Charu has plus money John has. That is 51,001 rupees 99 pais. Mathematics question number 23. The given pictograph shows the number of students participated in 5 different competitive exams. Study the given pictograph carefully and answer the questions that follow. What is the ratio of students who participated in exam Q to the total number of students who participated in exam R and S together? So, ratio of number of students who participated in exam Q to the total number of students who participated in exam R and S together is equal to 7:10. If 2/5 of the total number of students participated in P, R and T together got certificate of distinction, then how many total students got that certificate in these three exams? The total number of students in P, Q and T exam is equal to 24,375. So the number of students who got certificate is equal to 2/5 into 24,375, that is 9,750. What is the difference between the number of students who participated in exam Q and exam S? The difference between the students who participated in exam Q and S is equal to 4,375. Mathematics question number 26. Compare and fill the box. In the left side, we have to simplify it. And even in the right side, we have to simplify it using the BODMAS rule. So let us simplify the left side first. Simplifying, we'll get 48,116. In the right side, if we simplify, we'll get 1,449. As we can see here, 48,116 is larger than 1,449. So the option is C. Mathematics question number 27. A milkman sold 25.515 liters, 32.15 liters and 49.175 liters on milk on 1st, 2nd and 3rd day respectively. How much more milk did he sell on 2nd and 3rd day altogether than on the 1st day? Amount he sold on the 2nd and 1st day together is equal to 81.325 liters. More amount of milk he sold on the 2nd and 3rd day altogether than on the 1st day is equal to 55.810 liters. Mathematics question number 28. Select the incorrect option. The LCM of 22, 38 and 144 is 1,254. Yes, this statement is correct. A number is said to be divisible by 9 if the sum of the digits of the number is divisible by 9. This is also true. The number 19,848 is divisible by 2 but not by 4. This is wrong because the last two digits should be divisible by 4, which it is divisible by 4. So this statement is wrong. Mathematics question number 29. Suppose a driver drives from the surface to 248 meters below the surface, then swims up 6 meters, down 17 meters, down another 24 meters and then up 23 meters. Find the driver's depth after these movements. Let us take the meters as negative integer when he dives below and up as positive integer. So if we do that, minus 248 plus 6 minus 17 minus 24 plus 23, which is equal to minus 260 meters. So this can also be written as 260 meters below the surface. Mathematics question number 30. Which of the following statement is correct? A. A parallelogram in which two adjacent angles are equal is a rectangle. Yes, this is true. A quadrilateral in which both pairs of opposite angles are equal is a parallelogram. Yes, this is also true. In a parallelogram, the maximum number of acute angles can be 2. Yes, this is also true. So all of these are correct. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe. Hit that like button, turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye.